Hello, thank you for watching me again. This is a Yoga Reflections. Today I'll talk about the distractions, how there are so many worldly distractions, and those distractions are just there to keep you from the truth. There is a factual truth that you can know that it's true. That is that you're going to die. Because you're alive, you know that's going to happen. So if you live according to the truth, then you're living knowing that you're going to die and that there's not much time left before you die. Then that would lead you naturally to do what's really important in life and what's important for your soul, what's going to stay in your soul after your body dies. Because in truth, your soul doesn't die. And even if so, people that believe that the soul dies, then, or that there is no soul, then what would be the purpose if you still know that your body's gonna die and your whole self is gonna die? Anyway, so I would like to share a story or something that happened to me a couple of days ago. I was feeling a little low, you know, when your energy is low and negative thoughts start running around. So I was having like all these negative thoughts, worries and concerns, fears. I came home from my yoga practice with Reno and I almost wanted to fall in my bed again and not do the things I needed to do. And I decided to work on my translation. I'm translating the Srimad Bhagavatam from English to Spanish. And I was translating a story of Dhruva. Dhruva was a 5-year-old boy, son of a king. He was the son of the king's first wife. He was now married to his second wife, and he had also a new, like a baby, baby with the second wife. So Dhruva was 5 years old, and then the king was with his wife and their son, playing. And they were playing, and then this Dhruva, who was just 5, came to the king and wanted to play because he saw them so joyful. And he asked the father, but the king didn't really listen, so he kind of ignored him. And his wife was very happy that the king ignored Dhruva. So she turned to him and said, you are not going to have the throne because only a child from my womb, it's dignified or deserves to have this kingdom. So in your life, Dhruva, you should work every day, practicing austerities, practicing your prayings, to pray, maybe get rid of all your impurities so that in your next life you can be born from me. And Dhruva started crying so much and went to his mother. And he's like sinking in his tears, went to his mother, and the mother tried to give him some comfort. And then she said to him, remember this, don't worry about what she says. Remember about the very one truth she told you. That is the truth that if you practice austerities, and if you pray, and if you devote your life to God, then everything is possible. The tears calmed down, and Dhruva then realized he wanted to become, to find the truth of yoga and find the realization of God. So Dhruva started craving for a guru, for a true teacher. He went to the Himalayas. He gave up all the worldly attachments, and he went and seek of his teacher. Then Narada is a saint that lives in all astral planes. felt the thirst of Dhruva, and Narada came to him. Anyways, long story short, with the time and the practice, Dhruva became enlightened. And for me, in that moment, after reading a five-year-old boy becoming so enlightened, so wise, and giving up all the worldly worries and attachments to just realize of the truth, then that was a big lesson for me. No more worries were in my mind at that time. So my invitation is to really keep your practice on studying texts like the Srimad Bhagavatam, like the Bhagavad Gita. And this is all for today. Keep studying. Thank you. So you can find me if you like these videos, add me, like my page on Facebook and add me on Instagram as Jimena_yoga. I will be glad to stay in contact with you. Thank you very much.